good afternoon, members. It's now the appointed hour. Before we start the business of the prior to business, we request members to ensure that any items related to private or confidential or exempt information are not on display until such time that information is required in confidential settings. Request any person present intending to record the proceedings of the meeting to make themselves known to the chair. So I'd like to welcome Mr. and Mrs. Rice. Thank you for coming along today. I've got an announcement to make. The authority meeting on the 16th of December 2014, following the consideration of the JJC official opening report at the authority meeting on the 2nd of October, requested that members consider changing the start time of the authority meeting on the 16th of December. As a result of the response from members regarding the proposed time change, the Chair of the Authority has confirmed that the authority meeting on the 16th of December will commence at an earlier time of 11 a.m. and any pre-group meetings should be held at 10:30 hours if required to ensure there is no clashes with the event. Is that agreed? Right, preliminary matters. Apologies for absence. I've got Councillor Cadden leaving, needs to leave early. Apologies received from Kieran Simmons and Ian Cummins as representative. Any other apologies for absence?
I may leave it there. Don't let you know.
Any declarations of interest from members? To consider the matter of urgency, which is the special papers. I want to add some to the minutes of the community protection meeting held on the 29th of July as submitted for approval. They agreed?
Agreed.
Now move on to item 4 on the main agenda. Item 3, sorry.
One thing I will bring to members' attention is on page 32, the quality of
the party plan has changed to that, and you recall, moved away from a quota of an effect of recruitment to recruiting people into the service that reflect the communities we serve, and that will be an amendment which made part of the release. So just to reinforce the request to the members, the report is and the recommendation is that members approve the content of the 2015-17 integrated management plan subject to change. A 12-week consultation period. I'm happy to take any questions about any specific detail contained within.
Thank you. Any comments or questions from members? Okay,
page 31, the quality about risk factors associated with people living in rented properties. The action point above it only seems to relate to registered social landlords, and what was on my mind was that the private landlords were, I would have thought there was a likelihood of more risks than with social registered landlords. I just wondered where we were on that, and that was that sort of approach.
Absolutely, you are quite correct. The biggest risk is probably black properties owned by private landlords. The challenge for us as an authority is we have the data available to us around RSL properties, so social landlords we are able to establish the numbers, the locations, who owns what, if they are a better provider of the tenant's property. The challenge for us is, and we do, let me be assured, members, we do work with private landlords to provide some good options.
It's just to continue on for the charter itself is going to, the implication of it is that there will be a register, hopefully by the time it's all finished, with all private landlords directed, that's it. It's going on the back of the legislation that's there. So, you know, can we have a report back on that? Because from what I can gather from the way we're doing in my board, is that literally you hope to have every landlord registered, whether they be RSL or private, specifically, as with most of them, I can only even live in this country. Many of them actually live in Southern Ireland, etc. So, you know, this is the kind of charter we need, so we know who they are for problems in the future. So, maybe once you get a report back, you come back with us on that, because I think it's an important issue.
Absolutely, sure. And if I was to say, there's an aspiration to be able to map out all of those who provide the event accommodation, whether they be that data is readily available and to be accomplished.
more for local authorities in conversion of city and areas of our property, which is part of the density class,
comment from me then, the actual consultation to the developers, will it be full consultation that we do with the IRMP when our old fire districts with the
Yes, absolutely, and
the purpose of this report is to advise members of the operational recruitment strategy for 2014-15 and to seek your endorsement for the construction terms that we are proposing to apply. At the budget meeting on the 27th of February, members approved subject to considering the outcomes of public consultation. The substantive structural changes to the operational response model that would result in four of our existing whole time fire engines being crewed on a whole time 10 basis, and that of course is what the members think in year operational response savings required for 24 hours, which are 2015-16, as I was saying. As you're aware, members, those budget reductions take effect as of the 1st of May. Subsequently, at the meeting on the 2nd of October, earlier this month, members approved the merger of Heighton and Weston to deliver a one pump whole time retained station at Prescott. That was after the public consultation. And you also approved the 12-week public consultation which we're in the middle of now, and the public meetings commence on Monday. Which is for the merger of West Kirby and Upton at the new site in Gleesby. Again, one pump whole time retained. You approved an outright closure of Alton, again subject to public consultation, where the fire engine at Alton would be relocated to Old Swan, again to be crewed on a whole time retained basis. And as you're aware, members, we have a further merger proposal for St Helens, which is a merger of the existing Eccleston fire station merged with the existing St Helens fire station and a new site within the St Helens town centre. When I spoke to the report on the